The Yankees have been talking about landing Andrew McCutchen. Our buddy Joel Sherman from the New York Post saying, here Yanks are working to try and finalize a deal with the Giants for McCutchen. Not done yet. Abitail Avellino would be part of the return for San Francisco. Joel later tweeted that it would be two prospects for McCutchen. And then Buster Olney of ESPN just tweeting this, Yankees get McCutchen via a source. So Jack Curry is now standing by. He is outside the Yankees clubhouse. Jack, what can you tell us about the McCutchen deal?
Well, the rumors started circulating about a half an hour ago. I believe Joel Sherman of the New York Post was the first to report it. And you have Buster Olney of ESPN saying that it's a done deal now. So I think we can assume that Andrew McCutchen is now a Yankee. And we've talked about this a lot, guys. We talked about it in the broadcast tonight. Would the Yankees try and add an outfielder? When I asked Brian Cashman about this about a week ago, he talked about how some of the prices were higher than what the Yankees were willing to go to, but I think it's become readily apparent that they need some help in the outfield. And you look at McCutchen, is he the same player he was back in his Pittsburgh days, where one year he had 194 hits and he was a perennial 300 hitter? He's not that hitter, but he's a very reliable player. I think 255 this year with a 357 on-base percentage, 15 homers, 55 runs batted in. This is a player who can help the Yankees immediately.
By the way, Jack, do you think this is also them at the very least hedging the bet that maybe Aaron Judge is a little further away now than they expected?
I think it is. I mean, when we spoke to Aaron Boone today about Aaron Judge, he said that he has still not gripped a bat. He has still not tried to swing a bat. Now, when you look at the number of games that Judge has already missed, he has already been down for 33 games and still hasn't swung a bat. If you're the Yankees, you're trying to add reinforcements. We know Sanchez is coming back and will be activated on Saturday, but in the outfield, they've been looking for help. No offense to Shane Robinson, but they never expected Shane Robinson to get the number of at-bats that he has gotten. This is a guy who has gotten about 50 at-bats. So I think you plug in someone like McCutchen and you bring yourself a much more professional hitter, and you make yourselves better immediately when you add McCutchen to the lineup.
Jack, you've talked so much about the Yankees being disciplined, getting under that luxury tax number. I'm assuming this move will stay the course with that?
Yeah, our crack researcher, Jeff Quagliata, is on that. He told me that McCutchen's addition would be a shade over $2 million. We're looking at about $2.25 million. So I think that was obviously a factor, Flash, in the Yankees not wanting to go above that luxury tax. They've been beneath it until almost September. They're not going to go above it now. So I think they're trying to make smart, practical decisions to make themselves better. And we'll know more about Judge's situation as we move forward. But when you add McCutchen, you're adding a player who, let's be honest about it, he's a better player than Shane Robinson. And Shane Robinson has been getting a lot of starts for the Yankees lately.
And Jack, final thing on McCutchen, you're also adding a veteran player from a losing team right now that comes to a team that's right in the fray and battling for a wild card spot and what they hope eventually will be a division title. How much can a guy